Just a couple weeks ago, I finished my first semester of university towards my degree in computer science, and I learned some things. I took 5 classes this semester, and in this video I'm going to run through and let you know what I learned in each of those university classes. My first class was English 100, which taught me a very important lesson, which is to look up your professor before you enter a class. My professor for English 100 did not like people. Honestly, I can't blame them totally. If my life was to mark essays, I would hate people too. I'm pretty sure I got matched up with the hardest marking professor that was in the entire school, so it wasn't the most fun English thing. But other than that, I learned, like, what? Passive voice sentence structure, I guess? Great, you know, it's fantastic. Math 110. The one thing I learned in Math 110 is that Math 110 is exactly the same as calculus in high school. So that wasn't a waste at all. Music 101. Now, you're probably thinking, why'd you take a 101 course? That's an introductory course. You're not gonna learn a whole lot in a 101 course, especially since you've taken, like, 8 years of band in your previous... Yeah, okay, whatever. Listen, my degree is, like, half elective, so I gotta take some easy classes. And I did learn a cool thing or two in music class. It was good. It was a fairly good class. I learned a couple things. I learned how to do this.
Yeah!
Yeah, that'll definitely help me in all my future endeavors. Oh yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Creative Technologies 110. Okay, listen to that. Creative Technologies. It sounds right up my alley. Creativity and technology. It's what I do on YouTube all the time. It's my favorite thing. And so I come into the class, and I'm like, oh, can't wait to see what kind of creative stuff they're gonna get me to do. It's gonna be a good time. 1 week later. Okay, class. Today we are going to be playing Pokemon Go and writing about our experience. What? Needless to say, Creative Technologies didn't live up to my expectations. This is what I wish they would have taught me to do in that class. And finally, the class that actually seems to matter towards my degree, Computer Science 110. Now, I learned a lot in this class, namely, how to program very simple C++ programs. And that is kind of fun, and I learned to do all sorts of fun stuff with it, as you will see right here. I've done it. I've created the ultimate C++ program. Let's see how it works. name. Easy. I suppose. Let's see. Yeah, that should be good. Make quality content. Oh. Hey, there's a text file here.
Listen, Luke, you are in dire need of a reality check. I mean, you want to become YouTube famous? Really? Do you honestly think you're going to be able to pull that off? There are so many other people already doing that exact same thing but better than you. What makes you so special? You think that if you make quality content it will get you any closer to your delusional plan to become YouTube famous? Spoiler alert, it won't. Besides, you're far too young to be working towards something like that. By the time you get serious about your dream, people will have moved on to something else. We all know there's no money to be made trying to become YouTube famous anyway. Unless you're super lucky, which we all know you aren't. Just give up now, and work towards doing something productive for society.
If for some reason you guys want to try this out yourself, you can download it, link in the description.
So, I've basically summarized everything that I learned in the first semester of university. Now, the question arises, was that worth the approximately $3,500 of tuition costs? I think the answer is pretty clearly no. No, not worth it, not in a million years. But maybe it will be worth it when I finish my degree. After I spend, what, $28,000 or something? No, not that much. Well, actually, maybe that much. Wait, about 7 times 4? Yeah, $28,000 for an entire degree in computer science. Will that be worth it? Will it allow me to get a career that will work? There's no way to know, but I try to be optimistic about it. That, of course, is all assuming that I survive the crippling isolation of living 4 hours away from your friends and family on top of the constant weight of tuition costs and dread of future hurdles that are in the way of your success, compounded by the insurmountable self-doubt that comes when you wonder if you're choosing the right path or if you'll ever be able to be happy with whatever career you'll end up with. As each passing day, you ponder your ultimate goal, wanting to take every step you can to achieve it, but it's so hard to start because no matter how close you get, it still feels much too far away, so you focus on the next test, or assignment, or YouTube video you're gonna make, or live stream you're gonna do, so you can distract yourself from actually accomplishing anything. Also, you can feel like you're making progress when that voice in your head reminds you that your time is limited, but you still squander it anyway. You procrastinate, you wait till tomorrow, and before you know it, you're out of time, you've accomplished nothing and gotten nowhere. That got really freaking dark, really freaking fast. I'm not gonna worry about it too much. Next semester, I'm taking 2 computer science courses, a creative technologies in electronic dance music production, an English class, a math class, and what else is that it? Yeah, I think that's it. It's gonna be pretty good, maybe. I guess we'll see. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. I think it was a pretty good time. I'll see you in the next video. Don't know when that's gonna be. See you then.